Leia here from leiafirstsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I want to talk to you about the 2019 MCAT test dates and what it means for you. As of this recording, the dates are just out, but registration doesn't open until October. Now, typically, the way this cycle works is that the dates come out in September, registration opens for half of the testing cycle in October, and then the following year, around February, registration opens for the remainder of the cycle. This year is slightly different in that the United States and Canada have different schedules with more test dates in the US. There are the winter dates in January, and then the regular season opens in March, going all the way through September. That means there are no MCAT dates October, November, December, and again, nothing in February. So what does this mean for you if you're trying to figure out the ideal time to register and then the ideal time to test? It's not just about the perfect time on the calendar. There are two things you want to take into consideration. The first is the calendar and how that applies to your plans. And the second is you. You have to make it custom to you. Regarding the calendar, Canada is easier because most schools simply have a hard deadline. Your application has to be in by a specific date, and if it's in, they'll evaluate, and if it's not, they won't. This means you can test any time as long as you get your scores before that hard deadline. The United States is different in that most schools operate on a rolling admissions basis. That means the earlier you apply, the earlier they evaluate your application. Chances are the earlier you get your secondaries, earlier interviews, everything happens a little bit faster. And obviously the sooner you apply, the sooner you submit your secondaries, the sooner you have an interview, the greater the chances of getting accepted. So let's look at the timeline. You can start working on your application as early as May, but the applications themselves can't be submitted until June. Early June for MD and later in June for DO. There are two more things to consider with a timeline. The first is that it takes about 30 days to get your MCAT scores. So if you test early June, you're not getting your scores until early July. And the second is that the application itself still has to undergo a verification process. Now, this typically takes anywhere from a couple of weeks to longer. I've seen it take as little as 2 weeks and as long as 6 or more. When planning your application cycle, you want to make sure you account for the time to get your score and the time it takes for the school to get your verified application. Keeping this in mind, in a perfect world, you would want to have your MCAT done in May so that you have your scores and your application ready to go the day you can hit submit in June. The problem is, it doesn't always work out that way. That's why I said in a perfect world. Let's face it, you have school, you have family, you have other things, maybe you need more time to study. If you can't have your MCAT done by May, it's not the end of the world. Because if May was the only time to test, why would there be test dates in June, July, August, and September? So if you're trying to find the best time to test, definitely get it done by June or July. August and September is pushing it a little bit. You're getting to the end of the cycle and your chances go down. That being said, I've had students who are in medical school right now who tested in September. Yes, their applications went in late. Yes, their interviews came late. Yes, they spent months on the waiting list, not sure if they were getting accepted, but many of them did. Some didn't, maybe because of their application, maybe because of the timeline. You have to take all of that into consideration. Which brings us back to number two. The second thing to help you determine when to test is you. If you are rushing to take your test early, but you're not ready, that just means an earlier MCAT, earlier scores, earlier to realize that you should not have tested and now have to test again, but in the meantime, you wasted 30 days while waiting for your score before realizing to test again. Instead, just make sure that before you go sit your MCAT, you know you're ready so that you're not wasting any time in between. I recommend that my students sign up about 3 months before their MCAT, maybe even two, because by that time you have a good idea. Am I on track? Am I making progress? And do I think I'll be ready in time? What you're looking for is enough time in your schedule for phases 1, 2, and 3, which I explain in detail in the article linked below, but this gives you enough time to get through content, enough time to practice passages, enough time for full lengths, enough time to track and watch your scores go up, and to work on the issues that come up if they're not going up, And if you're worried about test dates disappearing, yes, it happens. But think about it. Say you sign up for the MCAT in October. And then by December, you realize you're not ready. What do? You postpone. As soon as you postpone your exam, a seat opened up and another student is able to snatch it up. If the seats are gone, check back by the deadline for the gold and silver zones. That's about 30 days prior, because as students are dropping and postponing their exam, another seat will open for you. You have to keep looking. You have to be persistent. But I've had a lot of students panic when there were no seats, and they kept checking, and eventually they got a seat. Even a student in Anchorage, Alaska, where apparently they only have one testing center with 8 seats where she was looking, she was all ready to book a flight to Seattle, but she managed to find a seat at the last minute, and she managed to take her MCAT in her hometown. If you're not sure how to start, and you're overwhelmed by all the conflicting information available online, I get it. And I've got you covered. I wrote a guide to help you figure out everything that has to happen in your MCAT prep, from which classes to take, what subjects are on there, how to figure out when to test, how to figure out your target score, and then the studying steps, from setting a proper schedule and managing your time and what resources to use and all of that. You can find this guide on my website by visiting MCATstrategyguide.com. And you can also download the companion workbook to keep track of everything as you move along. The link again is MCATstrategyguide.com.